Hey everybody, White Bear Dan here. Welcome back. Today, let's talk about divorce, dating, the pandemic, all those things, lots to talk about. Okay, so I figured this is about time to make this video about divorce and dating. Now it's almost, oh my gosh, going on a little over 2 years, 2.5 years since my divorce. And dating's looked kind of weird. And I think what's really impacted it, of course, would be the pandemic. I mean, straight up divorce, not divorced. The pandemic definitely impacts single folks, especially if you're a little bit older. I mean, it's been my experience. One is that things are closed. It's very hard to like have a date or meet somebody at a coffee shop or whatever when it's all closed, when there's social distancing, you don't really know, everybody's nervous. So that's like a big piece of the dating landscape right now. And then we're all kind of dealing with it. What I will say as far as being divorced and rushing into dating, in hindsight, like, I'm glad I didn't do it. Like, to be honest with you, I didn't, I've dated a few, but not really extensively, partly because, my life is so busy. It's very hard to start dating somebody and then make them realize that they're not the priority in my life, which is a whole other issue. But what I think was just really, really hard about the dating is that, I know, if you've ever been, if you know anybody who's been in AA or in recovery, one of the things they'll tell you when you're in first recovery is you shouldn't date for the first year. And part of that is because they want you to really focus on yourself. Like, they don't want distraction. They want you being emotionally invested in somebody else when you need to be emotionally invested in yourself. And that's pretty much the same frame I took with my divorce. I really stayed away from dating the first year or so. I really was not interested in it. And it was just something that, looking back on, I'm so glad that I took that time off and, just used that time to work on myself. The other thing that was really interesting about when, you get divorced, and if you were like me and if you stumbled on this video, you're searching for answers. And it's very similar. If you're a male, you're going and obviously going to gravitate to, hey, what are other guys saying? What are other guys that are going through what I'm going through saying? And I got to be honest with you, that's when things started to get really lost in the weeds for me. There is a ton of stuff out there, if you're a man and you're watching this, and you've heard of the manosphere, you've heard of Red Pill, you've heard of MGTOW, these are all things that if you're kind of a man looking to improve your self, self health or what, all that stuff, you've stumbled upon these things. And I'm going to say that, I'm not here to promote either one. What I will say is that you should be aware of them. I'm a person that's very anti-intellectual ghetto, meaning that you should not surround yourself with people that say the same things as you do, think the same things as you do. You should go out and seek dissenting opinion. I just believe that that's really what we lack in today's society overall. But for me, I am never, talk about alphas and betas. I'm more of a sigma. Like, I'm much more of like my own drum. I am not interested in the system. I am not interested in playing by the rules. Interestingly, I do, and I'm an educator and those are other things, but personally, I go by my own drum. Like, and many of you might be sitting out there and be like, yeah, listen, I'm not looking to get a Lamborghini or a Ferrari or like a mansion with an indoor pool. Like, that's not what drives me. So there's those things that, like, what you do, intrinsically to push yourself forward. And in that journey, you're going to find a whole bunch of opinions about, women and dating and who you shouldn't date and who you should date and the apps and all, they could talk about the apps, but there's just so many aspects of people's opinions out there. Like I'm giving you mine, and opinions are like a-holes. Everybody's got one. And that's why many of us, YouTube people or whatever, any creator, anybody who's making a video, puts this stuff out there is because you have some sort of opinion and some sort of experience in it. And you're like, you know, when I was out there searching, what I wanted to hear was difference. I wanted to hear different perspectives. There are a lot of great perspectives out there. Obviously, listen, if you're a man, you should definitely be reading Rollo Tomasi's Rational Male. There's a ton of good stuff in there. There's a bunch of great YouTubers out there. There's Rich Cooper up in Canada. There's this, you know, Coach Greg. There's a ton of guys, you know, even the Better Batch. Like, there's a bunch of guys that really have been doing this a while. They're really articulate. They have some really good frame. They have a ton of coaching experience, or they're able to like have had a lot of experience talking to a variety of men. Those are all really, really good perspectives to have. The other thing is too, is like, you know, like it is very easy to sit there and listen to a whole bunch of guys have the same conversation. I would imagine it's hard for many guys who are in this to kind of get an opinion from a woman. I luck out. I happen to work in a field where it's predominantly women, and I am sometimes the only male in the room. And interestingly, I do get their perspective, and it kind of does give me some insight, like some insight that I didn't have, and probably helps me in my future relationships, you know, if I go down that road. But it was really important that in this journey that I was getting everybody's insight. I was getting the guys, you know, the manosphere guys. I was getting, you know, what the feminists are saying. Like, what is everybody saying about this? Because at the end of the day, I just want to know, like, for my own sake, on my journey, what's available out there? Who am I dealing with? You know, the other big piece of dating in the 20th, 21st century is the apps. So let's talk about the apps. The apps are a complete, absolute nightmare. I gotta be honest with you, it's like, you know, I don't wanna sound like some sort of boomer, but it is just bizarre how you're using the phone to pick our future mate. And, you know, listen, there's tons of studies on what the apps, what they're actually gathering, who's swiping on who. You know, predominantly we know this, that if, you know, that women are going to be swiping on the top 20% of guys. And so that's great. There's a bunch of guys out there. There's a bunch of guys out there achieving it, killing it. You know, they got great game. They got good social media. They're making some bank. You know, they're doing all the things that women would aspire to in a mate. Like, get it. Like, it's what we're all about and what happens when you're dealing with the apps is that the women are gravitating to a very small percentage of men. One, you know, like I was watching somebody, I don't know who it was, and they were talking about height and about, you know, like the, maybe it was like one of the Rich Cooper ones, but they were talking about like that only like 14% of guys in the country are over 6 feet. Yeah, everybody's looking for a 6 foot guy. And, you know, so like even the reality of what's achievable, I think that's where everybody is completely like off the rails. And now it becomes really hard, because now if you're a middle of the road guy, like who's a pretty decent guy, but you're not an upper 20%, nor desire to be one, like chasing after that. Like, I am not looking to have a great social media presence. I am not looking to take pictures of me in a swimming pool, driving a Lamb. Like, I'm not interested in all that game. So for me, like, it's very hard, because there might be somebody who I really connect with out there, but if they're looking for the pictures that's on this profile, I'm already excluded. That's really difficult to kind of like to grasp, because I don't know, it just seems like an utter waste of time, everybody's time, because the thing is those 20% of guys are being super, super selective. And they should be. They're getting the pick of the litter. And then what happens is all those other women feel like, oh, these guys are such a-holes. Look how they treat me. And then, you know, the other guys who are looking for somebody are all kind of caught up in it. It's just this endless cycle. So for me, the apps, I'm kind of done with them. Like, I don't reutilize them. I, you know, did profiles and tried different way. Like, I met a couple nice women there. But to be honest with you, it's just not not the way I want to do it. The other thing is when you're out in public, you know, everybody's wearing a mask. I have no idea what anybody looks like there. I have facial hair. Some women are not down with facial hair. I take off my mask. They're like, what the hell is on your face? The other thing is I have a white beard. You know, I could go dye my hair and make it look a little darker. And I got, luckily, good genetics, good skin. I could make myself look a little younger. But unless I shave my beard and start playing that game, it's... This is this game that you gotta play, and that's kind of the thing about what I've not bought into post-divorce, is the game. Like, I've been really just focused on what makes me better. Makes me a better father, makes me a better educator, makes me a better person. You know, like, those are the things that I've recognized have been much more important to me. You know, I'll talk about interacting with exes in another video, but, like, my relationship with people, like, I don't stress out anymore. Like, I don't have people in my life that cause me angst. And if they did, they're gone. I removed them from it. And I just felt like inviting dating into the scene really kind of complicates things, because there is an emotional investment for sure. There is a time investment. Your time is limited. I am a very, you know, I am jammed with work for most of the week. And then every other weekend, I got my kids. And, you know, that's a whole other thing. And then there's, of course, the financial investment. You know, they're, you know, you're trying to spend money, go out and do things. That's why you always got to do this return on investment. Like, what, you know, is this worth my investment in time, money, emotion? What am I getting out of it? And then, you know, pros and cons. What am I not getting out of it? Yeah, at times, of course, you know, you do feel a little lonely. There's, you know, we're in the middle of a pandemic. You know, everybody's kind of locked down. You can't really go out and, you know, interact with anybody. So there are times you can get in your head. And that's where it's important you're figuring out how you're getting out of your head. What do you, like I talk about in other videos, what's the plan? Are you exercising? Are you taking care of yourself? Do you have a hobby? Do you have some sort of distraction? So those are all the things that just kind of made me, not like have to worry about like getting in my own head. My ultimate goal, like, it's interesting, I'm recording this video, whatever, 2.5 years, who knows what the future holds. I never say never. I am kind of one of these guys always willing to change, go with the times, go with the flow. But what I do know now is that if I do decide, like, hey, the relationship is the thing I want to do, I'm gonna be much more equipped to do that. I've gotten to the point now where I'm starting to be much more reflective of why my first marriage didn't work, my second marriage didn't work, why my relationships are just not working in general with people. Part of that is, you know, my own mental health issues. You know, part of that is just not being, you know, committed to certain things. Part of that is just, you know, having different interests. It's a multitude of things, you know, and for you, it might be completely different. But at the end of the day, you know, at some point you clicked on this video and hopefully you got this far into it, that, you know, you're post-divorce, you're like, should I date, should I not date? You know, obviously that's up to you. I am one of these people that found real value in not dating right away, or if I was dating, it was very sparingly. I did not commit to anything. As a result of that, I think things went really, really well. Hopefully, once this whole pandemic kind of gets over and we're back out and about, I think that's where I feel much more comfortable looking for somebody. I'd much more rather, you know, I was not one of these guys that went to clubs or whatever and hooked up. Like, I am not that dude. Most of the relationships I got into women were through people I knew, like, whether I was, you know, they were friends of a friend, or, you know, we worked together, or, like, they were in my circle, in my orbit. And I think that's kind of what I like about dating people that I already know. Because the thing is, you know, you meet somebody on an app, it's like an interview. Like, you got 10, 20, 15, half an hour to kind of scope each other out, see if you're kind of compatible. But at the end of the day, I think kind of it's important that I want to know what that person's about. Like, and that, you can't figure that out over a cup of coffee. Like, I want to know who they hang out with. I want to know who their friends are. I want to know what they do for a living. I want to know, like, why their previous relationships. Why are you single at this point in your life? Like, all of those things definitely will be a big decision maker on whether I am going to put my time and money and emotions into that investment. And, you know, I think hopefully you're approaching it the same way, because there's, you know, there's, as I'm kind of ticking off years on the clock, I'm past half a century. I know, I don't, you know, like I'm on the back end, I'm on my back nine of life, and I want to spend it with quality people, and hopefully you do too. So I think, you know, finally I kind of wrote and made this video. It's, be honest with you, this is the third time, maybe the fourth time I record that, this video, but maybe this is it. Maybe this is the one I'm editing. Maybe you're watching it. As always, thank you. Please consider subscribing, like this video, share with your friends, and as always, peace.